morning, everybody. I am Tibor Juhász from Hungary. I work at the Eszterházy Károly College in Eger. This meeting is organized in the frame of the Tempus project, Visuality and Mathematics. I have been keeping my eyes on the project since its beginning, because my task is to maintain the website of the project, which is certainly often visited by all of you. And in last year, when 10 Serbian students came to Hungary for a short study period, I turned up as a cook. I cooked the goulash for the delegation. And 1 year later, the management told me, Tibor, many thanks for the lot of work you have done for this project. This is very nice. However, you are a mathematician. You should deliver a lecture in the frame of second student exchange for Serbian students. Well, I said I have at least 2 reasons for why not. The first is my pure English, and the other one is that the subject of my research is group algebras, and the abstract algebra is not easy to visualize area of maths. Whereas everybody can imagine even nowhere continuous functions. I don't know how to imagine an omnipotent group. they said we see, but please send us the title of your lecture as soon as possible. I couldn't do anything else. I started thinking about where groups and rings and algebraic structures are around us. And at the time I visited my grandma's, and I managed to find non-abelian, non-nilpotent group on her table. On this table cover, there is the theater group of order 6. Then I decided to devote my lecture to show the way how we can get from the table cover to the group symmetries. I just want to show the elementary part of this this area, which can be followed by elementary knowledge of geometry and algebra. Okay. The first few words about symmetry. The everyday notion of symmetry has a very vague and somewhat limited meaning, like balanced, well-proportioned, harmony between the parts, and so on. We say that things or living organisms are symmetrical if they have parts that are mirror images of each other. The prime example is the human body. The mathematical notion of symmetry incorporates these properties, but the definition is more general. The symmetry is defined by operations and transformations that leave some aspects of the transformed object unchanged. Objective mapping of a set X onto itself is called a transformation of X. For example, if X is a set of points in a plane, the reflection is a transformation of the set X. The composition of two transformations is also a transformation. This circle denotes the usual function composition. And in this way, this circle can be considered as a binary operation on the set Sx. Sx denotes the set of all transformations of the set X. And this binary operation satisfies these three conditions. The first means that the function composition is associative. This means that the transformations are associative, but it follows from that the function composition is usual associative. And the identity map is, of course, a transformation of the set X. As the set SX has a neutral element under this circle operation. And every one-to-one correspondence is invertible, so every transformation has an inverse, the composition of transformation and its inverse gives the identity mapping. What does it mean? It means that Sx forms a group under this operation. Okay, let now y be a subset of X. Y could be an object, a figure, an image, pattern, and as you like it. By a symmetry of Y, we mean distance preserving transformation, in other words, an isometric of X under which the set Y is invert. So this is the concept. This is the Rigo's definition of the symmetry. This is the mathematical definition of the symmetry. Returning back to our table cover, the reflection in this red line is a symmetry of this object, and any more symmetries? Yes. There are two other mirror lines, and if we consider the rotation by 60 degrees and 120 degrees around the center point, we have other two symmetries, and of course the rotation by 316 degrees with the identity symmetries. Okay, after this the rigorous definition of the symmetry, here are some variations of that from leading researchers of mathematical symmetry. The second one is my personal favorite. You could think of the total symmetry of an object as all the moves that the mathematician could make to trick you into thinking that he hadn't touched it at all. I think this is a very, very good approach to the mathematical symmetry. After that we looked at the isometries in the plane. Everybody knows the all isometries in the plane are the following: so translation. Okay, a translation has no fixed point, and the other one, a reflection in the line. This transformation has infinite many fixed points. The set of fixed points is the mirror line. And next one is the rotation about the point by a given angle. This transformation has only one fixed point, the center of the rotation. And the last one is the glide reflection. This is a reflection in a line combined with translational that the same line. It can be proved that these four are the all isometries in the plane. Now we will say what will be the composition of that. The composition of translation will be translation. A composition of an identical rotation and the translation is rotation and translation will be a rotation. A composition of rotations is rotations or translations. It depends on the sum of the angles. A composition of reflections. It is the most complicated. It's up to the state of the mirror lines. If over intersecting lines, the composition will be rotation, and across two parallel lines is equivalent to a translation. And over the same lines, the composition will be the identity mass. This means that the reflection is a transformation of order 2. The square of the transformation is the identity transformation. Okay, I didn't list the other combinations. This is your homework at the lecture. In Hungary, I delivered two-hour course, and I had some time to present some proof, but I think this facts belongs to the standard geometry, and nobody heard from that. Okay, symmetry group. Come back for a time. So these facts led us to the fact that the isometries in a plane forms a groove, and of course this is a subgroup of the transformation groups of the plane. Okay, and this is true in general, not only in the plane. The full symmetric group of an object or a set is the group of all symmetries of the object. And the subgroups of the full symmetric group call the symmetry groups of the object. We will distinguish three types of symmetry groups. The first one is the point group. The point group is a group of isometries that keep at least one point fixed. It follows that a point group cannot contain any translation, because the translation has no fixed point. So this is a group without translation. And we will need the notion of continuous and discrete symmetry groups. A symmetry group of an object is continuous if for any positive epsilon and point P of the object there exists symmetry f from the group, from the symmetry group, such that the distance between the image of P and P is greater than zero and less than epsilon, and the symmetry group is discrete if it's not continuous. A symmetry group is continuous. Continuous means that the image of any point can be arbitrarily close to the point, and the meaning of the discrete is it's not. And Our aim is to classify the discrete point groups, and these point groups sometimes called rosette groups. It's not an accident. We first proved some properties of discrete rosette groups. It cannot contain rosette groups cannot contain any translation. It's trivial because rosette groups has to keep at least one point fixed, so a translation has no use for it. The second fact was if rosette groups contains rotation, its angle has to be 360 degrees per n with some positive integer n. This effect follows from the discrete properties because this properties guarantees that if we apply this rotation finite many times, it will be sooner or later the identity. Okay, the third fact was rosette group doesn't contain two rotations about different points. So if a rosette group contains the two or more rotations, the center has to be the same. And the last one, if rosette groups contain both rotations and reflections, then the axis of reflections passes through the center of the rotations. This is not so hard, these statements are not so hard to prove, and as far as I remember, we done the proof of non-trivial statements. And after that, we know that these statements are true. We can have the following description. There are two types of discrete rosette groups. The one type contains only rotations of this angle. And if we denote this rotation by f, F square denotes the applying this rotation two times, and if the angle is of the rotation is this, evidently the, if we apply this rotation by n times, we will get the identity transformation. So this is the first type of discrete rosette groups. And the second type contains reflections beside rotations. And if we have rotations, of course, the group contains all powers of this rotation. And T denotes the reflection in a line which passes through the center of the rotations, and of course T is a transformation of order 2, so T square is the identity map. And if we have two transformations in the two symmetries in the groups, the composition of symmetries should also be in the group. So Ft denotes the composition of the rotation F with the reflection T, and F square T the composition of the rotation F square with the reflection T, and so on. And it's easy to see that we have two times n elements, and these two times n elements are the all elements of this group, because if we circle F. So this is the changed order. These elements should be between this along these elements, and we have proved that the elements TF is equal to Fn minus 1 T. Okay, and we it's easy to give a formula to show how to change F with T. Okay, now let's see again our table cover. So what kind of symmetries we can see on the picture? What will be the symmetry group of this table? As we mentioned before, we have three reflections because we can find three mirror lines, and we have three rotations, two non-trivial and trivial rotations. And if we take the composition of those, we get that the symmetry group of these table covers will be the dividend group of order 6. I forgot to mention that this group is called the dividend group of order 2. And this group is called a cyclic group of order n. Okay, but what about the symmetries these two table covers? What is the difference? The colors are not essential now. Okay, this is not essential. Okay, if we look at this this cover, we can find four reflections, four mirror lines, and four. How many mirror lines?
Two?
With two less.
Four.
Four. Four and rotations?
Four.
Four, yes, by 90. Yes, 90 degrees. And it follows that the symmetric group of this these covers is the dividend group of order 8, yes. And what about the second cover? There is no mirror line. Okay, there is only rotation. If we don't care with the colors, we have only rotations. We have four rotations: the identity and the rotations 19, 118, and 270 degrees. So these two covers are similar, but the symmetry group of the left is the dividend group of order 8, and the symmetry group of the right one is the cyclic group of order 4. Okay. And the next step is to consider the symmetry groups with only one translation. And of course, if a symmetry group contains one translation, then the group contains every powers of this translation. And these groups are called freeze groups, and the freeze pattern is an infinite strip with a repeating pattern, like a pattern from colossal cell. What kind of symmetries can be found in this pattern? So translation is yes, translation is of course, and reflection, vertical reflection, and rotation. Okay, rotation around this point, and I can see I can also see a line deflection. Okay, we have a possibility to classify the freeze groups similarly that we done there, this for the rotate groups, but it's a bit more complicated. But we can done it using elementary methods, using elementary facts from geometry and algebra. So I would like to show you the seven freeze groups through Hungarian folk needlework. The group, the symmetry group of this pattern contains only a translation. Okay, this is a sketch or to visualize the symmetry. Okay, and the second one contains the translations and the glide reflection. Okay, the translation and the glide reflection. The distance of glide reflection is the half of the distance of translation. The second patterns has a symmetry of rotation by 180 degrees. Okay, and the center of the symmetry is here, and the center of the symmetry is always the half point of the the insect determined by the translation. Okay, this is the first three, and the next three. The first, the fourth type contains a vertical reflection beside the translation. If you look at this picture, you can see that this is the prime, the part, and this is the vertical reflection. It's the only one symmetry, and we can get the other part by translation. Okay. The fifth type is horizontal reflection. This pattern contains reflection in a line which is perpendicular to the distance of the translation. And the second, the sixth one contains a glide reflection, rotation, and a vertical reflection. As I remember right, this pattern from Kolodasek contains the, this sixth type. Okay? And this is, these two have the same symmetry, the full symmetry. And the last one is when the group contains vertical reflection, horizontal reflection, and rotation. This is an example for this pattern, and this is the simplified simplified figure to demonstrate these dimensions. Okay, we have only these seven freeze groups, no other. And every freeze pattern contains, belongs to one of the, these groups. I would like to show you some other other examples. This is a pillow border pillow from Buzsák. What kind of symmetries we can see? Besides translation, the six-star. Yes, because we have a vertical reflection, rotation, and then we have applied, we have also applied reflection. So the symmetric group of this pattern is type 6. Okay. The other examples below from Kolbaszeg. It works. It's works to make the difference between the top part and the middle part. The top contains only vertical reflection beside the translation. It was the group 2, maybe. I can't remember. Well, no. 4. 4. Okay, the symmetry group of the top part is type 4, and in the middle part, yes, so we can find vertical, horizontal symmetries, rotations, and maybe the cell. Yes, this is similar to this, and the pillow from Mezőkeszük. But I can only see glide reflections, yes? As type 1 or 2. 2, 2, the one was the translation only. Okay, and bed sheet from Mezőkövesd. Mezőkövesd is next to Eger. If you will come again, Eger, I recommend you to take a visit in Mezőkövesd, the Matyó Museum, and you can look at a lot of patterns like that. There. I think it's it works to make a difference between the top part and the bottom part. The top contains only a translation, yes, because this this animal is break the vertical symmetry. Okay, and this part. Vertical and horizontal symmetry. Yes, step 7, maybe. Okay, so I just want to show this pattern to you to show that Escher wasn't the only one who made symmetric patterns. We can find very nice symmetries in Hungarian needlework and Serbian needlework. Your homework is to collect a lot of Serbian folk needlework and study them from aspects of symmetries and classify then to these seven class of groups. The next step would be to generalize this concept for groups contains two non-parallel translations. These groups are called Brooks, but of course, in a lecture we have no enough time to present all three types. It could be a topic of another presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.